It's the 29th of December, and I find myself in Kingston-upon-Thames. Kingston is a very pleasant market town in West London. These days, it's probably best known for its shopping. But the town has a far greater claim to fame. Actually, it's one of the most important places in the history of England. You see, in the Anglo-Saxon era, this town lay on the border between the kingdoms of Mercia and Wessex. And so it was here, at All Saints Church, that seven kings were crowned. Edward the Elder, Edmund the First, Edwig, Edward the Martyr, Athelstan, Edred, and Ethelred. The coronation stone outside the Guildhall was supposedly what they sat upon when they were crowned. Now, I should point out that technically historians aren't so sure about Edmund, Edwy, and the Edwards, but this would be a very short video if I ignored them. So, who were the seven kings? Edward the Elder was crowned in 899 AD, often neglected by historians, but he's generally considered a pretty strong ruler who drove the Vikings from what is now southern England. Although, apparently, he wasn't much on book learning. Athelstan was made king in 925. He followed up on his dad's work by driving the Vikings out of York and creating a united England for the first time. He was also technically the first king to be crowned. Before him, the preferred headgear for kings was a helmet. Edmund I took the throne in 939. He's sometimes known as the Magnificent, which is a pretty awesome title, or the Deed Doer, which is also okay. Spent most of his reign fighting wars and eventually was assassinated. Edred became king in 946 and mostly seems to have spent his time fighting in Northumbria against Olaf Sigtryggsson, I'm probably pronouncing that all wrong, and Eric Bloodaxe of Norway. Edred eventually defeated the pretenders and died of indigestion, though I may have misinterpreted that. Edwig, or Edwy, took over in 955 at the age of 15. He argued a lot with his nobles and churchmen and was pretty generous with his land. He was also a bit of a lad, and actually I did another video going into this in more detail, link in the description below. Edward the Martyr only lasted from 975 to 978. No one seems to know who his mother actually was, and it was highly disputed whether he should have been king at all. Eventually, he was murdered at Corfe Castle, which is otherwise a very nice place to visit. His brother Ethelred followed, known as Ethelred the Unready. Not as you might imagine, because he wasn't actually expecting to become king, but because he got a smackdown laid upon him by the Danish king Swain Forkbeard, who took the country in 1013. A year later, Ethelred got the country back, and in 1016 he died, and the crown went to his son, Edmund Ironside, who was not crowned in Kingston. So there you have it. I hope you enjoyed this short and dubiously accurate history of the Kings of Kingston, and if you're ever in the area, check the Coronation Stone out for yourself. And I'll see you soon. Cheerio.